Most Republican presidential hopefuls right now are sitting on the sidelines, waiting in the shadows, trying to see just what the hell Donald Trump is going to do. Is he running? Is he not? I don't want to make him mad, so I'm not going to go out there and really do much of anything until he makes it clear what he wants to do. Everybody except one person, of course, and that person happens to be Tom Cotton. Because according to Republicans, both Republican citizens and Republican officials in Iowa and New Hampshire, Tom Cotton's up there all the time. And as they put it, he's, quote, pounding the pavement. He's knocking on doors. He's shaking people's hands. And he's basically laying the groundwork for his presidential run in these two early primary states, the two earliest primary states for some reason. Because Tom Cotton is just like, screw it. I want to do this. I'm gonna do this. Here I am. Come get to know me. And the worst part is, in addition to Tom Cotton being a terrible human being, it's working. Let me read you this. This is from Iowa GOP Secretary Jane Lane. This is what she said. He's much more personable than he comes across on TV, and I was really impressed with his handshake. You can tell a lot by these people, how they shake your hand. Thank you, Jane Lane. So Tom Cotton's there. He's making a good impression. He's personable. Oh, he's not like he is on TV, you know, the stiff and, you know, the guy that tried to convince Iran to get out of the nuclear agreement that they got into with President Obama. A move that, by the way, like when that happened, we all talked about it, like that was pretty much illegal. Like he should have been prosecuted for that because that does fit to a degree the definition of treason here in the United States. But rather than prosecute him as the Obama DOJ should have done at the time, nope, we let him live to fight another day. And of course, now he's going to run for president in 2024. Tom Cotton, the war hawk. There's a silver lining, though, and it actually lies within what Miss Jane Lane had to say. And I'm sorry if it seems like I'm making fun of your name. It just rhymes, and that's fun for me. He's better in person than he comes across on TV. Fantastic. Is he going to go and meet individually with every single person in this country? No, he is not. People, most of them, hundreds of millions of them, are only going to get to know him based on television appearances. So, that doesn't bode well for Tom Cotton. If you don't like him on TV, but you do like him in person, then guess what? You don't like him. Because we're not going to meet him in person. He doesn't have the time, the energy, or the strength to go to every single one of our cities. Especially before the real primaries kick in and Super Tuesday and all that, he'll be out of the race. You know, those Republican debates are brutal. They really are. And honestly, they're kind of fun to watch if you can get past the lies, because these guys go at each other like friggin' piranhas in tanks with great white sharks and saltwater crocodiles. Like, that's what we're watching when we see these Republican debates. It's so fun because they're all so vicious, because they all want that power. And Tom Cotton apparently wants it more than anybody else, except for maybe Donald Trump. So Trump could have a fight on his hands. Cotton may not bow out, even if Donald Trump says he's running. So we'll have to wait and see. But right now, things are starting to get fun. Thanks for watching. And if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.